Hi guys, I'm off today to talk to a bird expert to help me with my new book. It's set not far from where we're going. It's near Chippenham, and this guy's kind of an expert on bird life in Wiltshire, so it's going to be really handy for me. It's between Christmas and New Year. It's kind of a grey day, sunshine and showers. There's snow lying still on the hills. And this is an old road that leads from Bristol to Chippenham. When you go through villages, sometimes you'll see these giant pubs and you'll think, you know, why does it have such a huge pub? And that's because this used to be a coaching route. Back when we still used coaches and horses to get from A to B, and that was where the horses, there'd be like six horses and a big stagecoach, and that's where they'd stop to change the horses, and the people would get off and have something to eat, and they'd get back on and continue on. So there's some of these great big pubs along the way. It's farming country. So lots of, we're just going to pass a tractor now, people working. And I hit a bit of a flood earlier on, but so far it's kind of looking okay up here. So, not a lot of animal life out, but I have seen, a couple of crows, some rooks, and I saw a magpie and saluted it. And that's interesting because that's what I'm writing about. I'm writing about crows and magpies and corvids, is what we call the crow family, all together. And at this point, I'm not really sure 100% whether these are going to be magpies or crows or rooks in this book, because in my mind I just get it sorted and then they change. Here comes another tractor. So the first time I started to write it, they were all crows, and then when I wrote the first draft, they changed into magpies, and now I think they might be changing into rooks. I'm really not sure, but that kind of bit of it's okay, but it's the other bird life that I need to know about, what's around, when, what time of year, and how that's changed. And because, you know, I came into this country when I was already grown up, I didn't have a whole lot of time to notice animal life like you do when you're younger. I mean, when I was a kid, I would spend literally hours in a stream just holding my breath and sticking my face underneath to watch what the fish did, or I'd climb trees and just watch the squirrels, or, you know, lay on my back. I was once had a job laying on my back and counting the hawks that flew overhead. I've just come into Wiltshire. But as a grown-up, I've had a lot less time to do that kind of thing. So it's important for me to talk to the people who really know the life of the area. And that's why I'm going to buy Nick Adams a cup of coffee. Oh, here goes another flood. And have a chat with him. It's a fun part of writing, doing the research, meeting people, talking to everybody. And it makes a nice change from being, you know, locked into my shed or sitting at the end of my dining table all alone with just me and dog. It's nice to get out and get information from people. I'm also reading lots of books about birds. I've been studying how birds' brains work, which is fascinating. lot cleverer than we thought. And I'm also just finishing Crow Country by Mark Crocker, which is an amazing story, a study of rooks. So I've read lots of other stuff as well. But nothing, oh, there's a huge flock of crows just flying over right now. I wish you could see them. I like the way crows fly. They look all kind of raggedy and untidy compared to other birds. And that's because their feathers are angled differently. That's why when you see a crow flying, it flaps really lazily. And it can do that because of the angles of its feathers. It's a real long distance bird. It's not built for speed like the really tapered, neat wings of a swallow or a predator bird. It's built for distance. So when you think about, you know, as the crow flies, that's a measure from A to B that goes right across country. And that's exactly what crows do. They cover, you know, pretty big distances every day. And that's why their wings look so raggedy. It's because, especially when the wind's blowing like it is today, it ruffles those angled feathers and they look like they forgot to run a brush through their hair before they left the house. Less said about that, the better. So, off I go. Really excited. Looking forward to finding out more. And I'll put a picture up of me and Nick. And, you know, wish me luck. I've got no idea what these dang birds are going to be in the end. This manuscript, it's controlling me much more than I'm controlling it. See you later. Bye.